Hey guys, I want to show you recent changes on the U.S. debt clock. Look, it no longer says Federal Reserve. Now it says U.S. Treasury dollars. But if you look at the snapshots from different years, like for example, here's 2014, you'll notice it says Federal Reserve monetary base. It no longer says that. What do you think that means? U.S. Treasury dollars. Let me know in the comments.
Warning. This video may contain graphic language, graphic violence, gross cartoon penises, and a whole lot of Pimpy the pimp-ass pimp showing motherfuckers what's up. Viewer discretion is advised.
Welcome to Pimpy's Investment Chat, where we keep investment talk simple. And here's your host, Pimpy.
What is going on out there, peeps? Well, that was a good question he asked. What do you think this means? I see people posting this all over social media, but when you ask them, what does it mean? They just go, they're not reporting the Federal Reserve notes. It didn't say notes. It says the Federal Reserve monetary base. And when you ask people what it means to them, they really don't have an answer. They just get excited because they think it has something to do with the QFS system and all the other fun-loving stuff that people are talking about out there in YouTube land. Let's go over what this means so people have a better understanding of why it might be missing. Before we get started, do me a favor and hit the thumbs up button. And if you're not a subscriber, please do so, because when you do, it helps out the channel and I certainly do appreciate it. If you're thinking about buying gold, silver, or any other precious metals, head on over to our friends at Money Metals Exchange. The link is down below in the description, or just type in www.moneymetals.com/pimpy. If you make a purchase when you follow that link, you'll automatically be entered for a chance to win 10 free silver ounces. So get started today, and hopefully your stack will start to look like this real soon. So head on over, tell them Pimpy sent you. You can follow me over on other platforms. I do have my own group over on Facebook called Pimby's Investment Chat. Over here, we do talk about gold, silver, cryptocurrencies, as well as foreign currency investments. So head on over here and join us. It's free to do so. In here, I do post updates if I should get on suspension from YouTube or get removed from YouTube. And you want to know what happened to me, I'll let you know right here in this group. I can be found on Twitter, MeWe, YouTube, and the cool thing about YouTube, if you come over here and you join and you find my channel, I got videos going back, I believe, a couple years. So if you want to see some older videos that I have on Nicera, Jacera, gold, silver, cryptos, come on over here and join. Look me up and check out my videos. You can also find me on Odyssey. Catch me on Rumble. When I say that the links for all these are down below in the description, some of you don't know what I'm talking about. It's real simple. Just go down to the bottom right here of any of my videos. See this? This is the description. Hit show more. And there are all the links to all the platforms I just spoke about. So if you do want to head on over to Money Metals, just click it. And there you are. So come on over. Join us. I look forward to having you. Okay, just so people get an understanding of what is going on and what is being talked about. You can see right here the money creation. U.S. Treasury dollars, they show that there right now. What used to be there in 2020, it said Federal Reserve Monetary Base. Then you have the M2 money supply, the Treasury securities, the currency, and credit derivatives. So what is the U.S. Treasury dollars? Well, what Kennedy did back in his days in 1963, he had signed Executive Order 11110, which issued $4.3 billion directly to the U.S. Treasury, bypassing the Federal Reserve Bank. These debt-free, interest-free notes were known as silver certificates. So some of you might or might not remember what a silver certificate is. You look at your dollar bill, and right on the top here, it says silver certificate. Back then, if you had these dollars, you had a choice to turn it into the bank, and you were supposed to get its equivalent in silver handed back to you if you wanted to. Gold certificates, you did the same thing. You can exchange it for actual physical gold. With the silver certificate dollars, you can exchange it for actual silver. Now, obviously, we don't use those anymore, but I do find it interesting that they still have that showing on their books. So if you just go back to 2020, it did say Federal Reserve Monetary Base. So when I ask people, what does this mean to you? Because changes are made to the debt clock periodically. So it's nothing new. But what does this mean to you? Do you know what the Federal Reserve Monetary Base is? Most people don't. So why they're excited about it, I have no idea. But like I said, I have a feeling that somehow, some way, people have tied this into the QFS. This means something to it. So let me go ahead and run some stuff past you so you get an understanding of what's going on. So first of all, what is the Federal Reserve Monetary Base? The monetary base is a total amount of currency in circulation or held in reserves. Money in circulation is anything that is held and used by the general public, while reserves refer to commercial bank deposits and any money held in reserves by these institutions at the central bank. This measure of the money supply is not often cited since it excludes other forms of non-currency money that are prevalent in modern economies. The monetary base of an economy includes all of the physical paper and coin currency in circulation plus bank reserves held in a central bank. The money base is sometimes referred to as the high-powered money. It could be expanded through the money multiplier effect of the fractional reserves banking system. Understanding the monetary base, the monetary base is a component of the nation's money supply. It refers strictly to highly liquid funds, including notes, coinage, and current bank deposits. When the Federal Reserves create new funds to purchase bonds from commercial banks, the banks see an increase in their reserve holdings, which causes the monetary base to expand. It says right here, bank reserves held at the Fed may be exchanged for cash upon demand. In other words, bank reserve balances are a mere convenience for banks to relieve them of the burden of holding masses of cash in their vaults and shipping it to other banks to settle normal bank clearings. Anyways, you get an idea of what it is. It's the actual money that's out there in circulation. So what does that mean to us? Why would they remove that off the national debt clock? Well, I'm going to take a stab at it. My suspicion is, if people knew how much was actually out there and in circulation, when they go to move us into the central bank digital currency, you can't say we don't have enough paper money out there. Because people are going to go, what do you mean? It says right here we have X amount of dollars that are out there in circulation. So just print more and we'll hold on to these. They'll make every excuse just to try to get us to go into the central bank digital currency. But my guess is that they don't want people knowing the truth about how much is out there in circulation. It's kind of hard to tell people you don't have the money, that it's gone, that you're running a shortage on money, when they could just go to the debt clock and see that you have billions of dollars out there floating around. How can you be short? The other part of it is the overall national debt that we have. It is part of the equation that lets us know just how solvent we are. We're actually bankrupt is what it is. So if that's how many dollars are out there in circulation, then it's kind of hard to tell the people, well, we need to go to the central bank digital currency because there's a shortage on coinage or there's a shortage on dollars. And people are like, what do you mean? There's tons of them out there, man. So we should be able to do digital as well as physical paper. So yeah, my guess is that it has a lot more to do with the central bank digital currency more than anything else. And if you just hide that from the people, then it's kind of hard for them to question what the hell they're talking about when they drop this bomb on you that we have to go to the central bank digital currency because there's not enough currency out there. We have a currency shortage and it's going to affect the economy and whatever other excuse they need to use. So I hope that helps explain a little bit. Most people can't explain why it's missing, but yeah, that's the best guess that I can come up with, because that's all it does is keep track of the physical money that's out there in circulation. Why else would they need to remove it? Let me know what you guys think. I look forward to hearing from you. Over, I'm out.